Hello, everyone. This is Wen. I'm leading the user experience for Webex Meeting.
And hi, everyone. I'm Chris. I lead a team of designers and writers responsible for bringing our brand to life through strong visual language, storytelling, motion design, and UX writing across our collaboration portfolio.
Cool. Thanks for joining us today. And we're here today to talk about the new Webex Meeting experience that just launched in October. And the behind the scenes on what we do to design Webex. So it enables delightful, engaging, and a magical Webex experience that foster human connection anytime, anywhere. So there are certain products we use every day that make our life and work simpler and easier. Webex is definitely one of them. As designers, we are constantly looking at ways that we can make Webex collaboration products better. So hey, Chris, how about let's start with our design philosophy here at Webex. What's the design group philosophy that sort of unites our team?
Sure, so it's made up of a couple parts, but let me start here with our design mission. So our design mission is enhancing human connection by crafting experiences people love. And really the role of this mission is, it's essentially the underpinning of everything we do in design, right? So as designers, we're incredibly passionate about designing experiences that transcend language, culture, and even geographic barriers, right? And so ultimately what we stand for, what we believe in, is helping people connect and share ideas and ultimately get really meaningful work done together. And so that's what our design mission represents. The other piece of this is what we call our design values. And we have four values. And again, these are really this is kind of the belief system that we subscribe to in order to unify our design approach and deliver quality experiences consistently. So I'll go through this quickly. The first value is delight our users at every turn. And I'll just read through these. So with remote work now ubiquitous, Webex is the new workplace. It's where we transform busy work into meaningful work with ease, efficiency, and uplifting experiences that promote personal expression. So again, we strive to really delight our users in everything we do. The next value is create coherent systems. So our experience ecosystem has shared DNA, but not absolute consistency. And so what that means is that we adapt to every context naturally, so technology fades and the experience just makes sense. The third value is let instinct and data drive quality. So what this means is we don't shoot from the hip, right? We start with really strong instinct and then relentlessly test, learn, and improve to ensure we deliver best-in-class experiences that the world deserves. And then finally, enable smooth transitions. And what this means is that we flatten the barrier to entry so that minimal time is spent just figuring it out. And that means that guidance is readily available, answers are easy to find, and getting to work for folks is just seamless. And that applies to both experts and novices alike. So that's what we call sort of our design philosophy, our mission, and our values. So I think what's important now is let's take a look at how we actually bring these values to life in the work that we do every day. So Wen, do you want to take us down the path of looking at kind of where we've taken our product experiences over the past several years?
Sure, definitely. So let's look back 2017. The old Webex meeting layout is really not the height. It's technical, it feels transactional. You can see the meeting controls are hidden behind tabs when receiving screen share. You are actually meeting with buttons, not people. Also, it doesn't enable the smooth transition because it focused on controls and the technical aspects. It doesn't help you feel you are queuing up to meet face to face with people. Instead, it just feels like you are engaged in a technical transaction with the product. So that's why at April 2018, we promote a video-centric experience. So people feel like they are really there. They're connecting face to face. When you're in the meeting, you actually see people's video. Also, like centralized control bar, we put the most used meeting features into this centralized control bar for easy access. And today, we focus heavily on a modern real-time collaboration experience that help our user connect with their anytime, anyplace to do the most fulfilling work of their lives. So we're going to talk about that in more details now. The first thing we're going to talk about is our preview dialogue. So this is what you see before joining the meeting. I think Webex has led the industry standard in creating this more immersive preview experience that really is intended to mimic a real world experience. Chris, what do you think about this preview dialogue?
Well, I think one of the more striking improvements we've seen here is just that, like the preview window itself, and like the size of it and sort of how immersive it feels. I like to think of, you know, imagine attending an in-person meeting and consider your sort of pre-meeting ritual that you might go through. So perhaps you swing by the mirror, you take it, you know, you take a look in the mirror, you check your hair, sort of make sure you're, you know, you feel good and you're ready to go. Maybe you clear your throat, you're ready to go in, speak clearly. You want to feel prepared, you want to feel confident and ready to go. That's what we're trying to do here, is give people that opportunity to prepare, so they're not having to do that in the meeting, but they're doing that in advance. So they come in, they're ready to go, they feel confident, and they're ready to be to participate effectively.
Yeah, exactly. And you probably noticed about my background, right? So this is actually one of my favorite backgrounds designed by Webex. I think we also offer users to upload their own background image, but this Webex artist series is really, really unique. I feel like in my daily like work, right, instead of using the generic landscape or office sitting background, this Webex original illustration not only highly functional, but also provide a fresh dozen of personality to like my workspace. So Chris, as a visual director of the design group, do you want to talk through the underlying why driving this idea?
Sure. And this is my actual background. This is my actual office. Look, I mean, we know that being on, you know, video conferences for extended periods of time, it's exhausting. We know that. We're, you know, a lot of us are experiencing that now. Ultimately, what we want to do is we want to offer choice, right? So, you know, different video backgrounds that suit a range of different moods or personalities or even the audience that you're presenting to. I think by giving people more choice, we're going to allow people to just be more effective and again, feel more prepared and sort of ready to show up in a way that is relevant for them. You know, having backgrounds is not unique to us. However, I like to think that Webex is really the first to introduce this a strong underlying story that helps us move beyond just using stock imagery. So what you're seeing here is this is what we're calling the Webex Artist Series, and all of these backgrounds have been created by designers and illustrators on our design team. And so there's some underlying themes here. I think the inspiration that we've drawn on is we're a globally distributed organization. So we work across different time zones, geographies, cultures. And what that means for us is that we're influenced by a wide range of sort of places, right? And all of these serve as inspiration for the experiences that we create. Similarly, you know, we design our products for our customers who have, you know, diverse teams that are more often than not also remote and distributed in various ways. So there's kind of a nice parallel in this idea of, you know, looking for inspiration in a range of sort of global places and cultures and environments. And that's what we've done here to create these video backgrounds. So the series is made up of three different parts. The first is called Time and Place. And these are backgrounds that represent different natural environments from across the globe. And so each kind of evokes a different mood through the use of very simple illustrated form and colors. The next one is called Environments. And these are intentionally a bit unexpected and even a little whimsical. They're really intended to inspire imaginative ways to think about the different spaces that we occupy for work, for play, for learning, etc. The third part is or what we call neutrals. And you know, we see a need for backgrounds that you know that really have kind of simple texture and color, and they really recede into the background. And what this does is this allows the meeting participant to be the focus. And so these have very practical use, and you know, sometimes we need sort of a calm, familiar backdrop that really recedes and kind of falls away, and that's what these are intended to do. And you know, this is a starting point, and there will be a lot more to come. So we're excited to keep creating this series and building on it. So I think at this point, it's a good opportunity to shift and really look at some of the key improvements to the in-meeting experience. So Wynn, you wanna get into that?
Yep. So the default grid view, I think people all notice, right? This is one of the delightful design feature I really love, like in this launch, that just to make the experience of a virtual meeting that much better than before. I feel like giving people an overview of who they are in the meeting, the same way, like just like you walk into the real meeting room, quick scan the other participants and think to yourself, oh, good, like Ashley is here too. So you can see everyone's face, like emotions at the start of the meeting. It actually helps build the deeper human connection. I really like to use it with my team in my daily meeting. Also seeing my video as part of the grid view makes me feel everyone become part of the same space. We also provide like flexibility for the layouts. You like, if you want, you can also like dock your video out, or if you want to focus on the person who is speaking, then just use the top right, change layout control, then easy to switch to the speaker focus view.
So when another exciting thing, as we both know, that we've introduced is a dark theme. And so I think I like to think here, you know, to each their own. So some folks like a really kind of light, open area aesthetic. But for those who like a much more kind of immersive, kind of rich, cinematic quality video experience, that's where the dark theme comes into play. I love this theme, and it really helps our high quality video really pop off of that dark background. So we're excited to introduce this as well.
Yes, dark mode also my favorite.
Yeah.
And another, I think, big improvement is the docked style control bar. So this new control bar is actually designed deliberately to make sure that they don't obscure video and share content. Also, meanwhile, all the meeting actions and panel controls are separate grouped for easier navigation. You can actually access this anytime during the meeting. We also adding the contextual menu along the audio and the video button. So it allow user to easily change related settings, such as change speaker microphone or switch video camera. The new look and feel control with icon plus label is visually clear. And Chris, do you want to elaborate a little bit more about the design decisions that we went into making this experience better?
Absolutely. Let's first start with the problem though. We received a lot of feedback that the previous controls were just confusing. So for example, we had a mute button icon that always had the slash through the microphone, regardless of your audio status, right? And there was no label. And so it was difficult. It didn't clearly communicate when you were muted or not. And we also just relied too heavily on color alone to signal the status of your audio. So it just wasn't enough. So we've made some really positive changes. We now have a dynamic mute button that actually gives visual feedback for when sound is detected and when you're muted. Additionally, we've added, as you said, Wynn, we've added a label. And again, this helps to reinforce your audio and video status and just a generally provides more affordance for these controls. I'll touch very briefly, there are some kind of underlying design principles at play here. One is just intuitiveness. And what that means is that these symbols have to be the icons themselves and the controls, they have to be universally understood. That's just table stakes. So we've worked really hard to create the level of clarity that just makes sense here. Non-invasive, and you touched on this a little bit, Wynn, but how these controls show up in the UI is incredibly important. We don't want them to obscure video content. So we've worked hard to make that a reality. We still use kind of the same signature rounded style. So we've broken out of just the simple circle shape, and we now have this circular pill shape. And again, it has the same kind of visual style that our users will recognize, but we now can accommodate these labels for more affordance. Incredibly important. And then the third principle here is flexibility. And what that means is that these controls, they can adapt to fit the context. So the circle and pill shape can shape shift depending on the context. So from a large screen to smaller mobile screens, these controls can expand and contract to fit the space accordingly. So that's just some of the work that's happened in there. And we're super excited about this. We've worked really hard to make this possible.
Yep. Cannot wait, like everyone, to experience this new experience. Yeah. So last, let's watch a video from the designers in my team who actually made this happen. So hope you enjoy it, and thanks so much for joining us today.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.